If we look at any living thing, we don't see its DNA directly. We see proteins. We see the physical structures of the body. These are the traits, ultimately, that natural selection will be acting on. So how do we get from DNA to proteins? There is a very well-defined sequence in the flow of genetic information. We start out with the DNA. This is like the library, the repository, the instructions for coding the building of a body. And from DNA, we get RNA, which is ribonucleic acid, through a process called transcription. From the RNA, we then code for proteins through a process called translation. So let's look at this process in this video. We're going to start with DNA, go through to RNA, and get to proteins.
The information a cell needs to live, grow, and reproduce is contained in the cell's DNA. The DNA is divided into units of information called genes. In eukaryotic cells, the DNA is contained in the cell's nucleus, whereas proteins are made in the cell's cytoplasm. During transcription, information coded in the sequence of bases in a DNA molecule is converted into a sequence of bases within an RNA molecule. RNA then carries the information from the nucleus into the cytoplasm, where it guides protein synthesis.
So here we have our self-replicating molecule, DNA, and from that we're going to get to RNA, and from RNA we're going to get to the protein, and this is the stuff of our bodies. So the first step is called transcription. DNA is a long series of nucleotides, and so is RNA. The structure of DNA and RNA are so similar that information from the DNA can be directly copied or transcribed over to RNA. So we have a slightly different sugar. Instead of deoxyribose that we saw in DNA, that's the D in DNA, we have ribose. So this is ribonucleic acid. That's the sugar in RNA. There's also a similar sequence of bases. So whereas in DNA we had cytosine, thymine, adenine, and guanine, that's C, T, A, and G, so Gattaca over here, instead in RNA there's no thymine. That has uracil instead. So we're going to have now a different set of initials, G, U, A, and C. So I'll often refer to that as guac. Now the base pairing rules are very well defined in DNA. C can only pair with G, A with T. In RNA, it's the same with C and G, but now it's A with U since there's no T, and instead it's U. So, what happens during transcription is we start out with a portion of the DNA, it's not the whole length of the chromosome, but just one part of it, is going to be transcribed to what's called messenger RNA, or mRNA. So we're going to go along one rather restricted region of the DNA. This is going to be transcribed to produce a messenger RNA molecule. So we have the DNA, one of the double strand, one strand of the double-stranded DNA is used as a template, and that is then transcribed to produce an mRNA. U with A with T, G with C with G. Okay? So now we have some more videos here.
The start site is part of a region on the DNA strand called the promoter region. Transcription factors recognize and bind to specific base sequences in the promoter region. Transcription factors help the enzyme RNA polymerase bind to the promoter region at the start site. RNA polymerase immediately separates the two DNA strands. Only one DNA strand serves as a template for RNA production. RNA polymerase matches free ribonucleotides with their complementary bases on the template DNA strand. The first base will be the 5' end of the new RNA molecule. The RNA strand grows by the addition of new nucleotides to the free 3' end. A short RNA-DNA hybrid is made in the space where the DNA strands are separated. As RNA polymerase proceeds, the starting 5' end of the new RNA strand separates from the template DNA and begins to trail behind the polymerase. This allows the two DNA strands to reunite.
Okay, so there's a lot of details here that are unnecessary for this course. You don't need to know the names of these different enzymes. What I really want you to get is that we have the temporary separation of the complementary partners of the DNA. One strand is then used as a template, and then these individual nucleotides, or in the case of RNA, ribonucleotides, come in sequence to match what is complemented here on the template strand. Okay, here we go.
Base pairing rules are followed. A pairs with T, G pairs with C, C pairs with G. Because RNA is being made, U pairs with A. The sequence of bases in the RNA molecule is complementary to the sequence of bases on the DNA strand. RNA polymerase continues to add nucleotides to the 3' end until it reaches the stop site at the end of the transcription unit. The RNA strand dissociates from the DNA and is released. The RNA polymerase dissociates from the DNA and the two DNA strands reunite. Since the transcribed gene codes for a protein, the type of RNA molecule produced is called pre-messenger RNA, or pre-mRNA. Additional processing is required to produce fully functional messenger RNA. The 5' end of the RNA molecule is modified shortly after transcription begins. After transcription, the pre-mRNA is extended at its 3' end by the addition of many adenine nucleotides. This forms the poly-A tail. Some pre-mRNAs contain coding regions called exons, as well as non-coding regions called introns.
Okay, again, there's a number of details that we don't have to worry about, but I do want you to remember, because this will come up again later in the course, that we have some regions here in the messenger RNA or the pre-messenger RNA that are going to have to be excluded.
The introns are removed, and the exons are spliced together. The mRNA molecule is now fully functional. The protein coding region on the mRNA contains the sequence of bases that direct the assembly of a specific protein. This region is preceded by a short leader sequence and followed by a short sequence called the trailer.
Okay, again, we don't need to know about leaders and trailers. What we're really interested in is the protein coding region of the messenger RNA. So, we have first our DNA. The complementary partners are temporarily separated. One strand is serving as a template. Then it's transcribed to get this long stretch of RNA. And then there are certain bits, these introns, that have to be removed, leaving us with the coding region here of a proper messenger RNA. Okay, so we've gone from DNA now to a functioning molecule called messenger RNA.